Welcome to Azure Essentials. In the next few minutes, I'll walk you through the ways that you can integrate your on-premises networking, identity, compute, and data resources with Azure. I'll also explain how the development tools and practices that you're currently using can bridge between Azure and your locally hosted resources. Adopting a cloud-integrated or hybrid approach brings more advantages than if you were to uniquely host your infrastructure and services on-premises. Beyond the pay-for-what-you-use economics and elastic scale, compared to on-premises options, Azure gives you access to unparalleled advances in compute, allowing you to take advantage of the latest hardware, access to the most up-to-date intelligent security informed by billions of security signals, and that, combined with in-house and industry expertise and customer controls, help you to mitigate security threats. An advanced data governance, inclusive of our global compliance control framework, can augment your ability to stay compliant with the latest industry standards and regulations. The good news is that you can harness these benefits and more while continuing to leverage your on-premises investments. Azure's integration options comprise a broad range of services: hybrid network connectivity between your data center and the cloud, where you can connect your data center via virtual networks or more directly via express route. Azure provides a common identity model, which gives users the advantage of a single sign-on experience across applications and environments on-premises in Azure and other clouds. You can integrate your on-premises compute infrastructure with Azure and determine which compute resources run in the cloud versus on-premises, and then take advantage of things like cloud elasticity for scale-out or cloud-based failover. A consistent data platform allows you to keep your data on-premises or in the cloud and connect with data sources wherever they may reside. Management and security can be configured to monitor, manage, and secure your hybrid infrastructure, whether it's in your data center, Azure, or other clouds. And you can take advantage of a unified development and DevOps platform for continuous integration and deployment to any target, either in Azure or your data center with Azure Stack. Let's start with networking. Networking is core to getting your on-premises solutions to talk to Azure. Azure offers multiple approaches for configuring secure hybrid networking between your data centers and resources hosted in Azure. Azure Virtual Network enables many types of Azure resources, such as Azure Virtual Machines or VMs, to securely communicate with each other, the internet, and on-premises networks. You can implement multiple virtual networks within each Azure subscription and Azure region. Each virtual network is isolated from other virtual networks, and you can also use VPN gateways to send encrypted traffic between an Azure virtual network and an on-premises location over the public internet. Additionally, Azure Express Route is a private connection option that lets you extend your on-premises networks into the Microsoft cloud, facilitated by a connectivity provider. Express Route connections don't go over the public internet. This lets Express Route connections offer more reliability, faster speeds, lower latencies, and higher security than typical connections over the internet. Once your network connections are established between Azure and your data center, you can move on to identity and access management. Azure Active Directory allows you to have common identities between cloud and on-premises. It's a complete solution for identity and access management and extends to other Microsoft services, including Office 365, and to third-party services such as SAP, Salesforce, and many, many more. In fact, you see the full list at the link shown. If you have an existing on-premises Active Directory solution, you can extend it to Azure AD using Azure AD Connect, the recommended tool and approach for integrating your directory with Azure. Azure AD Connect allows you to configure the appropriate authentication method, including password hash sync, which securely syncs password hashes from your directory to Azure. Pass-through authentication, which authenticates in Azure using an agent to connect with passwords managed on-premises. Active Directory Federation Services, or ADFS, which handles authentication on-premises and may be necessary for certain configurations or requirements. These options will ensure that your users can use the same username and password to access resources in the cloud. Azure AD also supports multi-factor authentication and cross-platform APIs, including SAML, WSFed, OAuth, and more. With networks and identities integrated, you can move on to the compute options for running services like virtual machines, containers, and more. Azure offers a wide range of virtual machine options to support your apps and workloads, from low-cost VMs to support scale-out or simple dev test scenarios, to GPU-enabled VMs for high-performance compute, or massive VMs with up to 12 terabytes of RAM to support workloads like SAP HANA or Big Data. Both Linux and Windows-based VMs are available in the Azure Marketplace, and you can upload your own custom images. Virtual machines can be connected to your on-premises compute, and common hybrid options include dev test scenarios using VMs in the cloud, business continuity and failover in case of local service outages. But where the cloud really shines is with scaling out compute resources to meet elastic demand of specific apps and workloads. You can also use Azure Virtual Machine scale sets to create and manage a group of identical load-balance VMs. The number of VM instances can automatically increase or decrease in response to demand or a defined schedule. Scale sets provide high availability to your applications and allow you to centrally manage, configure, and update a large number of VMs. To learn more about your compute options, check out recent Azure Essentials episodes on the topic. Now, beyond unifying network, identity, and compute, a consistent data platform can bridge your data to securely integrate with Azure. You can configure your on-premises databases to connect securely to read, write, or transfer data between your data center and Azure using VPN, express route, or internet-based connectivity. In a hybrid configuration, you've got full control over where your data resides. You can keep it on-premises, in Azure, or both. Hybrid connectivity to Azure gives you a number of benefits, such as fast deployment and elastic scale. You can quickly set up and manage your SQL Server deployments and then scale up or down. We support both Windows Server and Linux platforms, including Red Hat, SUSE, and Ubuntu. And we give you the ability to lift and shift your databases with solutions like the new Azure Database Migration Service, so that you can move data with zero code changes to the cloud while maintaining full management control. You can also take advantage of high availability and disaster recovery for your backups through Azure Geo-Replication across multiple data centers, and also restore your backups to Azure VMs in the case of an on-premises failure. With Azure, you can also choose the Azure data centers to host your data to meet data sovereignty requirements. Azure Analytics services help grow your current data estate with solutions like Azure Data Lake, Azure Databricks, and Power BI. Whether that data resides on-premises or in the cloud, it allows you to manage, process, and transform any type of data into valuable insights and use AI to reason that data. You can check out our Azure Essentials on data visualization and data analytics for overviews on your options. Another core piece of integrating the servers and services you host with those running in Azure is getting to a unified management experience for operations and security. For management, you can integrate services in both directions to achieve a common dashboard and control plane regardless of where resources are hosted. Via Azure, you can use Azure Insights and Analytics to collect and analyze information end-to-end for Windows and Linux systems running on-premises or even other cloud platforms. Log Analytics is another Azure-based service that enables proactive insights and troubleshooting. The logs can be fed into the service from Azure, on-premises, or across clouds. These options use the Microsoft Monitoring Agent and Workspaces to collect information from managed resources. If you're already using System Center Operations Manager, you can integrate alerts from Operations Manager into Azure services. You can then use the System Center Management Pack for Microsoft Azure to let you monitor the availability and performance of Azure resources. The Management Pack runs on a specified server pool and uses REST APIs to remotely discover and collect performance information about the specified Azure resources. Beyond monitoring and troubleshooting, you can use common policy management and automation services with both environments connected from PowerShell, Bash, and DSC, to Azure Desired State Management and Runbox. The new Windows Admin Center provides a unified view and management console for Windows servers, whether they're hosted in your data center, Azure, or other clouds. It also performs native backup between your server infrastructure and Azure. In terms of security, common controls can be leveraged via the Azure Security Center, which can be configured to give you a unified view of your Azure and on-premises hosted compute resources. With Azure Security Center, you can apply security policies across your hybrid cloud workloads, reduce your exposure to threats, and detect and respond to attacks. Azure Security Center provides centralized policy management for security policies, continuous security assessment to monitor the security of virtual machines, networks, storage, data services, and applications to discover potential security issues, actionable recommendations to remediate security vulnerabilities before they can be exploited by attackers with prioritized and actionable security recommendations, as well as advanced cloud defenses with just-in-time access to management ports and whitelisting to control applications running on your VMs hosted in Azure. And you can configure your resources wherever they reside for log collection, search, and security analysis, including connected partner solutions. As you develop your apps and services, it's important that code and resources are portable enough to be hosted in your data center or in the cloud, helping enable hybrid configurations or dynamically extend resources to run your workloads via the cloud. Development tools like Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code, and scripting tools like PowerShell or Bash can seamlessly move between on-premises and Azure-hosted services. Visual Studio Team Services provides a full CI/CD pipeline for your applications, no matter which language you're using, and it can deploy to several targets on-premises or in Azure, including virtual machines, Azure Service Fabric, and container orchestrators like Kubernetes. With Azure, you can take this a step further compared to other clouds using Azure Stack, which allows you to host a subset of the cloud services offered by Azure in your own data center. Azure Stack lets your developers build and deploy software in the same way, whether it runs on-premises or in the cloud. And this extends to both infrastructure as a service components like VMs and networking, along with platform as a service options like blob storage, containers, Kubernetes orchestration, service fabric, and app service to create apps and microservices. Because Azure and Azure Stack offer the same services and the same interfaces, moving applications between the two is straightforward. And if you've adopted DevOps practices, this now works identically for Azure in the public cloud and Azure Stack in your local data center. You can then use your tools to create deployment pipelines for new apps and services. With simple changing of the targeted pipeline URLs, you can use the same DevOps pipelines between cloud, on-premises, or hybrid environments. So that was an overview of the primary integration options to connect your resources in your data center to Azure. For even more information on your hybrid options, check out the link shown. And you can learn all about your options for identity management, compute, data, and DevOps, and more by following the related topics on Azure Essentials. Thanks for watching.